The sun sets on Southeast Michigan, and inside Joe Louis Arena, it's a sea of red. The season opener for the 2010-2011 season, the Detroit Red Wings playing host to the Anaheim Ducks, face-off 2010 NHL style. Get great seats for every Ducks home game. Visit AnaheimDucks.com/ticket exchange as we look at our Ticketmaster starting goalies.
Well, what a story Jimmy Howard was last year for the Wings. Remember, they started the year in Europe. When they got back, Mike Babcock said, boy, if we'd had a third goaltender, he might have been done here in Detroit. Runner-up for the Calder Trophy as Rookie of the Year. What a season he had. And the same thing applies for Jonas Hiller. Really his first year, John, where he owned the goal crease as the number one netminder. He was impressive for the Ducks. He's going to have to be impressive early in tonight's game.
Hiller appeared in four games in the preseason for the Ducks, and his numbers were pretty similar to what he put up last year in the regular season. Glad to have you along, and we are underway. The first round draft pick from last June, Cam Fowler, a native of suburban Detroit, begins the game for the Ducks back on the blue line.
And as expected, Mike Babcock immediately gets a couple of big forwards, especially Johan Franzen, on the ice to oppose Cam Fowler. He wants to test Fowler with the big bodies of Franzen and Bertuzzi.
Stewart throws it to the right corner of the Anaheim zone, and Paul Mara, another new addition on the blue line, came over as a free agent signing from Montreal. Moves it up the boards, but not out, as Franzen kept it alive. Bertuzzi got a shot through. Hiller made the save, and it's Mara who collects the rebound in behind the goal, given a very rough ride along the boards by Johan Franzen. Jason Blake able to nudge it out of the zone, and the Ducks finish changes.
Yeah, we wondered who was going to be paired with Cam Fowler in the early going, and Randy Carlisle elects to go with the veteran Paul Mara. And I think that's a good idea. Kind of a calming influence. Paul Mara is a very soft-spoken guy, very thoughtful. New addition to the Anaheim blue line.
Pavel Datsyuk for Detroit, and his shot blockered aside by Jonas Hiller. Bobby Ryan moves it ahead. He's with Getzlaf and Perry, and for the first time into the Detroit zone come the Ducks.
Well, the
big
guns.
The angle, Perry got a shot on net.
Johnny, the big guns on the ice for both teams, Zetterberg and Datsyuk. You know, one of those two players has led the Wings in scoring each of the last five seasons, and that's the matchup Mike Babcock wants, Zetterberg and Datsyuk, to oppose the Getzlaf line.
Now it's Vishnovsky and Andy Sutton, another newcomer on the Anaheim blue line. They are paired together, and Vishnovsky handles the puck at the Anaheim stripe. Troy Bodie trying to poke it ahead for Bolesky, but he couldn't get it, and there's number 90 in red, Mike Modano. 1,459 NHL games for the North Stars and Dallas Stars. And this is the first one for any other franchise other than that. Of course, he's a Detroit native, and it's going to be a big season for him playing here in his hometown.
It's still real strange to see Mike Modano in any other uniform than the Stars uniform.
And, of course, number 9 is not available here in Motown, so he went with 90 this time around, a native of Livonia, Michigan, another suburb, as the puck has touched up back in the Detroit zone. Well, we told you about Cam Fowler. He becomes the second youngest player ever to don an Anaheim uniform. Only Oleg Tverdovsky, at a more tender age, played in the regular season as a Duck.
Randy Carlisle has had nothing but glowing praise for the youngster Fowler. Plays with a tremendous amount of poise, but that was during the preseason. The regular season is a whole different animal.
Just a few months removed from graduation at nearby Farmington High School here in suburban Detroit. He has a good amount of family and friends here. He's had about 15 people in the group that he was bringing, including his two younger sisters and his mother and father, would be at the game here tonight. Patrick Eves' shot is sticked away, and the rebound came all the way out to Helm, but he didn't get much on the shot. Rafalski holds it in, and he can't filter his shot through. Brendan Mickelson handles for the Ducks. And away he sends George Parros. Nice outlet pass there by Mickelson.
Yeah, and that's going to be a big key for the Anaheim blue line. That outlet pass, tape-to-tape passing to allow the forwards the opportunity to have some kind of a transition game. Remember, I think the Detroit Red Wings still are the best puck possession team in the National Hockey League. They don't give it up very often.
Mara holds one in and then fires it wide. Incidentally, the scratches tonight for Anaheim, Ryan Carter, a healthy scratch, along with Lucas Sabisa, the only defenseman not dressed in this game, and Aaron Voros on the fourth line, replaced by Dan Sexton tonight. Bobby Ryan's shot is blocked by Brad Stewart. Perry collects it behind the goal. We're 3.5 minutes in, no score in Detroit.
Now, Tony Ludman also obviously not in the lineup. He has not been medically cleared to play at this point.
At this point, he's not even on the Ducks active roster. He's on injured reserve, but is traveling with the team, and that's a good sign as he participated in practice yesterday. Lidstrom's shot misses the mark. Another 40-something on the ice tonight. Nicholas Lidstrom. His shot missed the mark last season. He led the Red Wings in ice time at the age of 39, and really no reason to think he won't do it again this year.
And he will be on the ice every time Getzlaf is out there for Anaheim as well. Nick Lidstrom voted by the players last season, John, at age 39, then the best shutdown defenseman in the game.
Erickson breaks up a neutral zone pass and lifts it back into the Anaheim zone. Getzlaf pumping with Zetterberg, who wins the puck to Datsyuk, shovels a backhander, and Hiller with perhaps his best save of the game.
Yeah, it is difficult for a goaltender to pick up the release point on any kind of shots that are backhanded towards the net. So that was a real good save by Hiller in the early going.
Todd Bertuzzi out right now for Detroit. He was questionable for tonight's game all week because he was hampered by an ailing back that kept him out of a couple of practices, but he's out there for Mike Babcock's club tonight.
You know, we should point out as well, Randy Carlyle experimented.
Good!
Franzen off the wing, missing on the short side.
During the regular season with Bobby Ryan in the middle as the center iceman. That experiment appears, at least for now, to be over.
A familiar face wearing an unfamiliar number here in Detroit, at least. Number 24 out for the Red Wings, Ruslan Soleil, and the Wings strike first. A shot off the wing from Filppula.
Johan Franzen is back, folks. He's been great during the preseason, and the one thing we know about Franzen, when he gets hot, he can put the puck in the net, and this is just a great pass from Filppula. One-touch pass. Watch this. Onto the tape, right back to Johan Franzen, and no wasted time as Franzen lays the stick blade down and just rips it short side against Jonas Hiller. That is a nifty-looking attack play, and Johan Franzen buries it as he pots his first of the season.
He missed 55 games a year ago. His surgery injured his ACL on his knee, and that was a big blow to the Red Wings a season ago.
Well, that's the thing about this Detroit team. I mean, you look at their squad. From the Olympic break on, they got healthy, John. They were the best team record-wise the entire NHL. Mike Babcock said, don't worry about us, folks. We are an elite team still. They're the oldest team in the NHL, but boy, do they have an awful lot of weapons up front.
Yeah, you mentioned the post-Olympic break. 16-3-2 in the final 21 games last season for Detroit, and they get another one right back. Hiller beaten glove side.
Mike Madonna. Yeah, Madonna gets the puck, pulls it into his wheelhouse, and Madonna, one of the reasons why a lot of folks think the Red Wings are even better than they have been in recent years. They have more depth. You put Mike Madonna as your third line center, and Mike Babcock expects to get a little bit more offense out of that group, and Madonna buries it. Ducks are back on their heels, but you know, look at it from that angle. Jonas Hiller has no chance. What a shot by Madonna. He uses both an Anaheim defender and one of his line mates as a perfect screen.
Madonna said during the preseason he is targeting 20 goals and 50 points this season as personal goals. And if you can get that from a third line center, as you were saying, Mike Babcock's options are going to be nearly endless.
Well, he's playing with a couple of good players. Dan Cleary on one wing, Yuri Hudler, who spent last year in the Continental Hockey League in Russia, is back. Another reason why I say the Red Wings are better than they have been in the previous 2 years.
Faceoff comes back into the Detroit zone, and now how will the Ducks respond? Obvious early adversity here in Detroit, a place that has not treated Anaheim well over the years in the regular seasons, and they find themselves on the short end of a 2-0 score not yet 6 minutes in. Line of Bolesky, Marchant, and Bodie out for Randy Carlyle's club. Bolesky gets a piece of the puck, enabling Bodie to keep it in.
Yeah, and the response is key here from the Ducks. They need to. I think, John, an issue during the preseason that was very evident to me a little bit too passive in the defensive zone, especially against this Detroit team. And believe me, it is not easy against this group. You have got to be challenging them all over the ice.
Zetterberg carries into the Anaheim zone, and he runs into Andy Sutton. Datsyuk pokes it along, but it's Sutton who comes off the wall with it and hoists it back through the neutral zone. Cronwall goes back after it as both teams get wholesale changes on the go. Franzen and Madonna, it's 2-0 Detroit. Ruslan Soleil moves it ahead. Bertuzzi deflects it in. Getzlaf shovels it to center. And a nifty job to handle it cleanly by Corey Perry. But Bobby Ryan can't carry any further than the blue line. Cronwall shovels it away. It comes off the wall to Ryan, who fans on it but keeps it in. Down low, it's Getzlaf trying to bounce off of Cronwall, and he does. Perry drags it in front. Backhand, great pass across, and Ryan couldn't get the shot away. It was blocked.
Yeah, Bobby Ryan was moving towards the goal line, and that puck, that attempted pass, was about 2 feet away from the stick blade. Unfortunate, the Ducks can't make a shot on goal.
Nice play by Fowler at the other end. He moves the puck away from pressure quickly, allowing Mara to clear the zone. And now it's Soleil from behind the Detroit goal. His defense partner is Brad Stewart, who diagonally dumps it wide of the Anaheim net. Sexton goes back after it. Mickelson poking along the boards. And another former Duck, that's Drew Miller right there, who comes away with the puck. Off his stick, it'll come out center. Soleil retreats through neutral ice. 12:15 to go, first period at Joe Louis Arena. The Red Wings on top 2-0 as Mickelson reverses one for Sheldon Brookbank. Angled ahead by Chipchura, and Perro sends it the rest of the way into the Detroit zone off the corner boards. Howard had to come out and play it away from the on-rushing Dan Sexton.
Saw the good speed of Dan Sexton. That's why he's in this lineup. Randy Carlyle looking for some kind of an edge on his fourth line. Burles takes a seat in the opener, John, to create space for Sexton.
Errant pass bounces off the side of the Detroit goal, and Jason Blake thought he got the touch-up, but icing is the call. And really, it doesn't matter what uniform he wears, it's a familiar sight when Mike Modano hurts the Ducks.
Now, he has been an absolute killer over the years against Anaheim. Look at the difference in terms of career points against Anaheim. Modano sits at the top with 82, and then you got to go all the way down to Brett Hull, who's 28 points behind him. That is remarkable.
No one has done more damage to the Ducks than Mike Modano, who shovels it back to the line. Rafalski dances around Blake, didn't get his shot through, and Blake takes the carom and scales it up the glass and out. Modano, who was covering the point, now wanders back and handles it for Stewart. Brad Stewart, former first-round draft pick of the San Jose Sharks, taken third overall back in 1998. It's Modano. Boy, he's got some jump. You know this is a big night for him. And Cleary now on the near side.
Hiller blocks the goal stick.
Modano again with it, and it's knocked off his stick by Koivu. Sutton moves it ahead, and Bobby Ryan has to retreat. And he clipped Cleary inadvertently. As it is, it's going to be a penalty nonetheless. And the Ducks down two will be down a man when we come back to Joe Louis Arena in Detroit.
Right, here's a look at the penalty against Bobby Ryan as we are back. Wings already with a 2-0 lead. And watch as Bobby Ryan is going to try and lift the stick over the head of Dan Cleary. It's an inadvertent clip of Cleary. He has not cut it. It will just be a 2-minute minor penalty. Wings on the power play. New assistant coach with the Ducks this season, Mike Foligno, is the assistant in charge of the Anaheim penalty killing unit. He has pledged that this group will play a much more aggressive style, John, than the penalty killing unit of last season. Remember, that was a real issue for Anaheim last year as they finished 24th overall in the entire league. That's not good enough.
Yeah, we heard Randy Carlyle talk with you about it at the top of our show. Last season, just over 79%. In the preseason, the Ducks were just over 76% on the penalty kill. This is a Red Wing power play that a year ago was ninth in the league, and they still got plenty of weapons. Zetterberg's shot is held by Hiller. With every Ducks shootout win this season, Pinnacle Landscape will donate a tree for the new tower being built at Chalk Hospital. Thanks to Pinnacle Landscape for their generous donation.
Awful lot of skill on this Detroit power play. And we've talked about this a lot in the past years, John. It's unique in that when Thomas Holmstrom, the left side of your screen, is on this unit, He does nothing other than go immediately to the top of the goal crease and bother the netminder, impair his vision. I've always wondered why more power plays around this league do not adopt the same type of approach. Of course, they don't have Zetterberg and Datsyuk to play with them.
Zetterberg shot off the right pad of Hiller around to Lidstrom, who holds it in. He's a big part of that power play, too. Nicholas Lidstrom, the quarterback's the unit. They retrieve the puck. Zetterberg drops it off, gets it back, and deflects it just wide. Great give-and-go two-man play between Datsyuk and Zetterberg. Lidstrom's shot is blocked, and the loose puck pounced on by Vishnovsky, who heads up ice shorthanded. On his own as Koivu goes for a change, so he throws it on net. That may be the first save of the game for Jimmy Howard as he handles the puck just about 10 minutes into the game for the first time. Lidstrom wraps it around and in. Hiller stays put and lets it go around. Franzen bumped there by Mickelson, who jams it out of the zone. 40 seconds remains in the high-sticking minor penalty to Bobby Ryan. 9.5 to go first period. Glad to have you along from the Motor City. As the Red Wings work with the extra man, Hudler drops it off. 54 points in 54 games for Dinamo of the KHL a year ago for Hudler. He pounces on that rebound momentarily, but Marchand gets control and is able to hoist it out of harm's way.
And that's the other thing about Hudler is that, you know, he was here the season before last, here in Detroit. So he knows Mike Babcock, he knows the system. And it's an easy transition for him to get back into this Red Wing lineup.
Final seconds of the power play wind down. Ryan's penalty is over. He's out of the box. Oh, and the puck came back right through the middle. Madonna let it go. That was nearly a perfect pass for Ryan, but he wasn't able to get there in time as Howard stick handles it away.
Johnny, that could have been a penalty against the goaltender Jimmy Howard. He dragged that puck through an area that he's not supposed to be able to handle it in.
Detroit turnover resulting in a deflection on net. Howard will hold on to that one. And we will step aside. 2-0 Detroit. We're in the first period at Joe Louis Arena.
Anaheim is proud to select from the Windsor Spitfires, Cam Fowler.
That's awesome.
Cam, you now know you're part of a big rivalry.
Yeah.
Welcome to the NHL. Congratulations.
Hazy, the Ducks were so fortunate in getting Cam Fowler. As you see him put on a jersey, they didn't even have a jersey with his name on it. They didn't expect in their wildest dreams that he would be available. And a look at his family that are here to watch him make his NHL debut tonight.
The Ducks had him ranked third. And so when he fell to 12, certainly he was not really in their plans. You're right. They had no idea that they might get a future franchise defenseman with that 12th overall pick.
Continues to be the calm, cool, collected customer we saw in the preseason here through the first 10 minutes of this season opener here in Detroit. However, he and his mates are down 2-0. Erickson in front. Zetterberg's shot glances off of Hiller and across the zone. Sutton nudges it behind the net for Vishnovsky, draws a couple defenders and moves it away. Vishnovsky with it once more. He got 16 games with the Ducks after coming over from Edmonton late last season, and played over 25 minutes in 10 of those 16 games in an Anaheim uniform as the puck goes out of play. Well, we got a poll question for you here tonight. Log on to foxsportswest.com and vote now. How many goals do you think the Finnish Flash will score this year? Less than 20, between 20 and 30, or more than 30? Log on right now, foxsportswest.com. Get your votes in, and we'll update you throughout the broadcast.
You got 27 last season in just 54 games. It was really a freakish season for Kane Solani, broken hand, broken jaw. At the time, he said, you know what, I think it's time for me to move on. But he had so much fun playing after the Olympic break and had such great success.
Right on cue, he very nearly gets his first of the year. Nice play by Blake, who took the puck away and then found Solani. And this is the line with Koivu that had some great chemistry late last season. Randy Carlyle, as you mentioned, went away from it in the preseason early on in the Bobby Ryan experiment, putting him at center, but went back to it at the end. And the hope is they can rekindle that chemistry here early in the season, because they were an offensive force down the stretch last season for the Ducks.
Well, it was an interesting year in that a lot of people expected that instant chemistry between Koivu and Solani to start last year. For whatever reason, it never really materialized. Much different story, as you mentioned, John, after the Olympic break.
Nicholson hounded behind his own goal, moves it along as Modano's with him stride for stride. Brendan Nicholson now in his third NHL season, breaking camp with the Ducks for the second straight year. And of course last year he was reassigned to the American League in early December. Chipchura dumps it in and Howard will play behind the Detroit goal. 6:20 to go, first period. Peros knocks it down in the corner, but his pass across doesn't find a recipient.
Jimmy Howard has not had much to do in this game. One of the things he has been working on a lot during this offseason is actually handling the puck. A breakthrough year for him last year. And his goaltending coach, Jim Bedard, has been working with Jimmy Howard on just doing little smart plays whenever he does get the opportunity to handle it. And the first time he handled it there a moment ago, he turned it over to the Ducks.
Howard ended up as a Calder Trophy finalist for Rookie of the Year. And maybe in a nutshell for this Detroit franchise, even their rookies are older. He was 25 as a finalist for the Calder Trophy. This is a team that broke camp with 12 players over the age of 30. And one of them turns 30 tomorrow.
Henrik Zetterberg.
So the list just gets longer. And that does seem to be the one question mark. While there are many people, I know both you and I like this Red Wing team a lot. I think they'll win the division, at least in the Central this year. But the one question mark remains, part of what really was their problem a year ago, can they stay healthy? Because they are a little long in the tooth. Getzlaf just out of the reach of Ryan, who play it off the boards, and then Howard way out to make the save.
The Red Wings protect the back door as well as any team in the NHL. And that allows their goaltender, Jimmy Howard, to play very aggressively. That last shot by Bobby Ryan, a perfect example. He was 3 to 4 feet out in front of the goal crease to make that save. You don't see that very often anymore in the NHL, where
here
goaltenders are that aggressive.
Winding it up through the neutral zone. Draped by defenders as his teammates change behind him, and Koivu wins the puck on the far board. Chopped at by Blake, but Datsyuk gets it back. Nice little stick by Koivu to keep a puck alive, and Maris steps up off the right point. Holmstrom rims it around to the near side, and Datsyuk, who is so renowned for his strong defensive play, helps the Wings clear the zone. Now it's Zetterberg peeling off the near side boards, and Fowler blocks his bid. Cronwall battling to keep it in at the point, and he does not as Marchand muscles it across the stripe. Pass up the middle that Zetterberg just gets a touch on to steer it in and then finish a change as he heads back to the Detroit bench. Brookbank from behind the Anaheim goal, watched by Franzen. Franzen had the game's first goal. Modano answered with another just 24 seconds later, and it's 2-0 Detroit. Soleil off his skate, put it back into the Anaheim zone, and Valtteri Filppula put it behind the net. Ducks able to break out, chipped up the wall by Marchand. Cronwall sweeps it away. Pass came back off his skate. And now Soleil has space.
Now Mike Babcock was asked about his keys to tonight's game, and he said, shut down Ryan Getzlaf. If we do that, I like our chances tonight. It's not easy to do. He talked about the Getzlaf line as being perhaps the most dominant line around.
Give and go between Bolesky and Bodie, and Bolesky deflected it wide. Or I should say Bodie, excuse me. And the Red Wings dump it back in. Matt Bolesky had a nice camp for the Ducks, got in 5 games in the preseason. Produced 4 points. Played a lot with Perry and Getzlaf, who bring it into the Detroit zone now. Perry dumped as he brings it to the middle, and there's Getzlaf. Spins it right back through the blue paint. Vyshnovsky with a one-timer, and Howard able to steer that aside. Perry without a stick delivers a hit on Rafalski, whose pass is offside at the other end. Perry bouncing around in the Detroit zone as we see the Alex Delvecchio statue here at Joe Louis.
The thing you love about Corey Perry, he will take a hit to try and make a play. He knows he's going to get drilled. Henrik Zetterberg and Brad Stewart lower the boom, but it creates an opportunity for Ryan Getzlaf. Getzlaf comes close to banking that puck in off of the skate of Jimmy Howard. And here's why Mike Babcock said we got to control Getzlaf in tonight's game. 22 points, the most points against the Wings in the last 3 seasons. And look at the fact that Ryan Getzlaf has played much fewer games than the other names on those list, on that list rather, who were all divisional opponents of Detroit.
And much the way Modano has hurt the Ducks over the years. Getzlaf has done a lot of damage to these Red Wings. Under 3 minutes to go in the opening period. Detroit on top 2-0. Filppula into the Anaheim zone. Watched by Fowler, who keeps him to the outside and forces him to just rim it around. Franzen from below the goal line. Back to Stewart at the line. His shot gets through. Hiller makes the save and reaches out and covers up. Once again, American Honda will bring you the three-star leaderboard this season. Players named the first star of the game will earn 3 points. The second star of the game will receive two. And the third star will earn 1 point. Last year's winner was Jonas Hiller. You said that he's probably going to have to be on that star list on a rather regular basis, at least early on this season, to kind of stabilize things here for this hockey club.
The Ducks have had some bad luck in the early going, with Tony Ludman being unable to play in the lineup because of his bout with double vision, and with Joshua Lupo still having issues with a back issue. Two pretty important players not available for Randy Carlisle here in the early going.
Yeah, you bring up an interesting point we should address. Joffrey Lupul is working out but has yet to be cleared to practice with the Ducks. I spoke to Randy Carlisle a couple days ago about that, and there is no timetable right now for his return. Soleil deflected it to the corner, then tried to use the glass to clear, and Hudler chases with Brookbank back in the Anaheim zone. Mickelson is there to help out. And up the wall, Getzlaf's pass across dangerously just out of the reach of Dan Cleary.
Next goal, obviously huge in this game. It has not been a great period for Anaheim, but if they can get that next one, they're right back in it.
Getzlaf, Perry, and Ryan out for the Ducks as they work in the Detroit zone. Bobby Ryan, 30 goals in each of the last two seasons. Behind the net to get it from Getzlaf. Drops it off. Perry wanted to bring it around on the wraparound, but Zetterberg got a piece of him and it rolled off his stick. Ducks keep possession. Getzlaf tries to center, and Ryan colliding with Perry. The shot from Dzhinovsky creating a little havoc. And Howard able to get the whistle as everybody falls on top of the Detroit netminder.
You know, when you think about the Getzlaf line versus Datsyuk and Zetterberg, where Anaheim has the advantage, John, they're bigger. They have more size. So get pucks into that crease area where they can better exploit that size advantage. They should be able to own the puck along the boards in the offensive zone, but get it back to the blue line and jam away at the rebounds. What makes this trio so difficult to hold? But that's a good stop by Jimmy Howard. He wasn't sure where that puck was. Dzhinovsky got a lot on that shot. And there's Perry and Bobby Ryan and Ryan Getzlaf, and certainly the Red Wings are well aware that especially Corey Perry has been known as a guy who is not afraid to fall on the goaltender in the hunt for a rebound.
Well, we saw Bobby Ryan mixing it up with Nicholas Lidstrom there at the end of the play. Of course, Ryan dropped the gloves a year ago here with Todd Bertuzzi, and not what these guys are known for, but never ones to back down either. The Ducks big line taking a seat with a buck 23 to go here in the opening period.
Yeah, John, with the Red Wing bench. The Red Wings are not the most physical team back on the blue line. Stewart is probably their biggest threat in that regard. Cronwall is a good open ice hitter. It doesn't really challenge anyone after the whistle goes.
A season ago, the Red Wings were led by Todd Bertuzzi, who had 80 penalty minutes. As he fights with Solani for that puck off the end wall. Under a minute remaining in this opening period of the 2010-2011 NHL season for both these teams. Bertuzzi on right wing. Banks it off the boards and goes around Fowler to get it. Fowler and Mara go after him below the goal line. Or up the board, Solani pokes it past the point coverage of Stewart.
Darren Helm in very strong defensive positioning for the Red Wings.
Oh, he turned it over in the neutral zone momentarily, but gets it back. Now it's Zetterberg, wide to the left side, and his pass across intended for Helm, but he was picked up by Sutton in the slot. Perry glides in on left wing, passes it across, but too far out of the reach of Getzlaf. Countering back, Helm with Datsyuk. Zetterberg goes to the net, Helm shot blocked by Dzhinovsky and behind the goal, and Lubomir goes and gets it. Sutton with under 10 seconds to go moves it ahead, and the Ducks able to clear the zone. The Red Wings have to get back outside. That's going to pretty much do it for the period.
Interesting adjustment from Mike Babcock, who puts Darren Helm on the line instead of Thomas Holmstrom. So it's more of a defensive posture taken by the Red Wings. Jonas Hiller was busy in the opening period. And the Red Wings managed to get two behind him. An impressive opening 20 minutes for Detroit. The Ducks look a little bit out of sorts, John, in the first half of the period, but things did start to settle down as the game moved along.
It was a 24-second span that cost the Ducks in that opening period. Goals from Franzen and Madonna just 24 seconds apart give the Wings a 2-0 lead after one period of play. Fans, we want to remind you that coming up in the season opener, the home opener, I should say, at Honda Center, you're going to want to stick around for Ducks Live post-game after the game, because we're going to give you a first look at our all-access pass to Ducks training camp from this past September, as we got an inside and up close and personal look at the players, the coaching staff, and what takes place at Anaheim Ice in an NHL training camp.
It was a much different training camp for the Ducks. Randy Carlisle started teaching defensive zone coverage on day one of camp, and the Ducks also shortened their roster much earlier in the training camp to try and get down to the final grouping to get ready for the start of the regular season.
Let's go down to the Ducks bench, where standing by is the captain of the Anaheim Ducks, Ryan Getzlaf, who joins us. Ryan, you and I were talking the other day about the leadership group here and the fact that because you're wearing the C, it's not that big of a change. But for you personally, what's been the bigger change? You got married or you're the captain?
Neither one's much of a change for me. I've been, you know, fully involved with my girl for a long time now, so... the C is just another thing on my sweater right now.
Now, incidentally, congratulations on both counts.
Yeah, Ryan, you mentioned to me that you talked to your father after you were named captain. It had to be a very proud moment for him. What did he say to you?
Oh, just to continue on what I was doing. You can't change anything when you get in this role. It's the same thing that got you here. I felt like I was a leader on this group for a long time now.
Let's talk a little bit about the opening period tonight. A sense that there were some jitters in the early going, some difficulty moving the puck out of the defensive zone, but did you feel it on the bench that things started to settle down as the period moved on?
Oh, yeah. I mean, the group we have a lot of young D-men out there, and it's always going to be those first jitters since playing in the Joe like this.
Ryan, thanks so much for taking the time again. Congratulations. Good luck.
Thanks a lot, guys.
He told me earlier this week, he said, it's kind of felt like my team, our team, for the last 2 or 3 years. So fittingly, he is the captain of his team. And his team trails the Ducks 2-0 after one in Detroit.